Everybody, happy Thursday. Why is it every time I do a video I can never remember what day it is? It's Thursday, right? Okay. It's Thursday. This is a particularly special video, as you can judge by the title. Let me just get right to it, because, and first I give me a second though. I hit the record button and totally forgot to get the window up so I can give you this story. Okay, as you can see, like I said, the title should tell you that I'm in search of, well, me and a friend are in search of two gentlemen who really blew us away. I mean honestly, and they didn't say anything. That's the thing about it, they walked by and didn't say anything. And judging by the way a person walks and how they carry themselves, you can pretty much drop a dime on what that person might be about, you know. So, like I said, these guys walked by and just had us in a complete awe. Just like, gosh, they're walking with their head held high, you know. They're so handsome. And I'm a bold woman. Usually, if I see something as beautiful as that or as handsome as that, I'm going to walk to it and introduce myself. But for some reason, I was at a loss of complete words. And we both were. And they walked right out of our lives, pretty much. So let me read to you. Let me just tell you the story, okay? Me and my friend decided to go down to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for the 4th of July weekend, which I advise to anybody, do not do that, because there were so many people, it was utterly ridiculous. I mean, we could barely get a hotel room down there, because the prices were just ridiculous. But we were able to get a two-night stay at Myrtle Beach, and we stayed at the Viking Hotel, which I recommend to people. If you're North Carolinians, or if you're wherever you are and you want to go to Myrtle Beach, stay at the Viking. It's a very nice hotel. But anyway, so that's where we were staying. And this happened on Saturday, so we got there on Friday, and Saturday we decided to go out and lay on the beach. So that's what we did. So we got out there and set our towels down, and we were all looking so cute. And there was a lot of people out there. I mean, a lot of people out there. And they were out there swimming and just having fun. And we were taking videos and taking pictures of little kids and their little... This year, I always enjoy going to the beach, because I love seeing the little bathing suits that the kids are in. And we saw a lot of toddlers running out there, just looking so adorable. And the little bucket hats, and well, the little boys we kept seeing were wearing the little bucket hats and the little boxers, and the little girls were wearing the prettiest little bathing suits. I mean, we had cute bathing suits growing up, but my goodness, these kids got all these neat designs, you know. And so we didn't have that. I was getting kind of jealous, but they were looking so cute. But anyway, while we were just people watching, pretty much, these guys walked by. And in fact, let me just show you what they look like. That's them. Those are the two gentlemen. Aren't they just gorgeous? I mean, not just physically, but I'm looking at it more in depth, but physically, these guys are very, very handsome. And so I was able to get, as you can see, a very clear shot. I got two pictures, this one and another one. There's the other one. So that's those are the guys. Those are the guys that we are actually looking for. I'd be lying to you if I told you that we weren't looking for them in a sort of romantic interest. These guys just really, really blew us away. So we went, we couldn't stop pretty much thinking about them, really. We couldn't stop talking about them, because these guys, all they did was just walk by. We're hoping and praying these are not psycho killers, you know what I'm saying? But these guys just walked by. They stood out from everybody else. All they did was just walked by, and their heads were held high, and they looked, they were just beautiful. It was a beautiful sight to see. And we couldn't help but just, wow, these guys are handsome, you know, act girly, you know. But we hated, after we were, you know, the next day on Sunday, we were leaving to go back home. We just hated the fact that we didn't introduce ourselves, you know, to these guys. And so we decided to be very bold and take the risk of posting an ad. Which I advise to anybody, use internet safety. I mean, this can be very dangerous, I have to say, because you can get perverts, you can get whoever to respond to you, And when you post ads like that, don't give your personal information out. Don't give your phone number. Don't give nothing out that could possibly have these people possibly kind of track you. You know what I'm saying? So I wouldn't advise to do this. A lot of people do it, but I wouldn't advise to do it unless you are absolutely sure this is what you want to do and that you have a lot of weapons, hint, weapons laying around, you know, in case you have to use one of them. So that's my public announcement on that. So we posted an ad. And it was up. I posted an ad. I'm going to read it to you, too. So this is what I said. See, this doesn't sound good. I mean, I'm really good at writing, okay? All right. On July 4th, 2009, in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, on the main strip, just 5 miles down from Ripley's Believe It or Not, which is a great museum. Gosh, if you love Ripley stuff, go to that museum. Okay. A friend and I were sitting on the beach between the hotels called Blue Hotel, because there's a hotel called Blue Hotel, because actually the building's blue, it lights up blue, and the Viking Hotel. It was between 12 noon and 3 o'clock p.m. out on the beach. My friend and I spotted two young Caucasian males that looked between the ages of 22 and 26. They were walking together, friends we assume, and they both had on white, knee-length, past-the-knee swim trunks, as you saw in the picture. They both had on shades, both with short haircuts, almost buzz cuts, almost. The tallest one was muscular and had shades with a strap, and the other one was a bit leaner, and his shades did not have a strap. See how detailed I am? I mean, I can find anybody. But if you really detail like I am, you can find anybody. All right. Our purpose for looking for these gentlemen was simply because they stood out to be the most well-dressed, most handsome, and most classy-looking men we have ever seen since we arrived to the beach. I was able to capture a quick and very clear picture of the two gentlemen. Should anyone recognize these handsome gentlemen, please contact me as soon as possible. These guys, just by not saying anything and walking from afar, have totally touched us in a profound way, which they did. It was almost like seeing two angels walk out of heaven and just like, wow, they stand out from everything. That's pretty much what it was. I lost my place. Oh, they had a presence that just took our breath away. I will leave it at that. But I pretty much described me and my friend as classy, ethnic businesswomen, which is exactly what we are. And never have been so moved by two gentlemen that we clearly do not know. We would like to get to know them someday, somehow. Please help if you can. So that's basically what this video is. Based on where I posted the ad, and, you know, it would be quicker to get a response on YouTube, because YouTube, everybody goes to YouTube, everybody. So that's what I did. Now, let me tell you the downside of this. I have gotten messages from men who, for the first batch of men, I would say the first four guys, or men, excuse me, because I don't know if they're men or guys, and both, all of them, their age range, so it was, you know, men. Many of the first four did not claim to be the guys, which was the fortunate thing about it. Unfortunate about it is they were all trying to hit on us, because I wrote the ad, because of the way I wrote it, and it intrigued them, so of course I didn't respond. This is bad. I just didn't respond to them. I'm looking for two gentlemen. I'm not talking to anybody else but trying to look for these two. So, however, this past weekend, I got a message from somebody who claimed that he was one of the guys in the picture and that the other guy was his brother. So, he was like, well, you know, this is me and that's my brother and we're from a certain place and we go to Myrtle Beach regularly and, you know, and maybe we can talk sometime and maybe one day we can meet up at Myrtle Beach. So, he left me his Yahoo and on Monday night we had a chance to have a pretty good 2-hour discussion. Like I said, I didn't disclose anything personal, you know, to try to find me. I'm not that stupid. I could be dumb on some other things, but I'm not dumb on that, okay? So, you know, talked to him, and it was a very good conversation. It was nothing out of the norm. It was nothing to be alarmed about. It was a really decent conversation. And the guy was more than willing. And I only talked to him so I can get clarification. I was like, please, verify that this is you and this is your brother, okay? Give me your pictures. And I, of course, I didn't ask until later. I didn't ask until much later. I was like, okay, well, you seem like somebody, you know, you seem somewhat decent. So show me your picture, okay? And he was like, yeah, I'll definitely show you my picture. I'm not home right now. Red flag number one. I'm not home right now, but I'm about to go home in 30 minutes, so let me get back to you then, and I'll definitely send you my pictures. No problem at all. I will definitely send you my pictures. I was like, okay. All right. 30 minutes later, nothing. He didn't come back on. Okay. Maybe he went to bed. All right, so am I. It's late. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm going to sleep. That's what I did. Sent, left a message in the morning on the messenger and said, okay, well, I'm going to be on all day, so should you ever come on, let me know, and we can exchange pictures. Nothing. Nothing until that night, until Tuesday night, around the same time that we met talking on there, he signed on for about 10 seconds, and then signed off. Okay. He signed on and signed off. All right. Maybe he didn't see me. Am I online? Because sometimes I sign on invisible. I was online. I wasn't visible. He saw me. Right. Okay. I'll just send an email message. Send an email message. Did I miss you? Did you not see me on? Okay. Well, when you get a chance, let's chat and, you know, exchange pictures. Okay. No response back. Wednesday comes along. I come on the same time again. And he comes on the same time again. This time, he stays on for about a little more than 10 seconds. Probably, I would say, about 30 seconds at most. And goes away. No message. No instant message or anything. So that led me to believe that this person right here could not verify or prove that he was said and said person. So that I wouldn't lie. I won't lie. That was sort of a disappointment. you know, because it was a very good conversation. It was nothing inappropriate or anything. It was actually business talk, really. But it was a very good conversation, and he put this out there that, you know, I am this guy, and this guy is my brother, and I'm this age, and he's the, and I will send you the pictures. I didn't get anything. So that led me to believe that this person, again, could not verify if he was one of the gentlemen or if he was, you know, said person. So he can verify. So pretty much the search is on, which is why I'm doing the video. I figured that if I did a YouTube video about this, then maybe they would come across it some way. So that's exactly what I'm doing with this video. So do not judge me. Pretty much. I was watching Mall Cop last night. don't you judge me. So that's pretty much what this video is. Just trying to find the guys, pretty much to say thank you for making our Myrtle Beach trip. I've been to Myrtle Beach a bazillion times, but my friend's first time was that weekend. So she enjoyed it, and it was a very memorable trip. We really had a good time. Despite some of the crazy, I could tell you the whole story. Some of the crazy stuff we saw, it pays to not really hang out at night. My Lord, oh my goodness, the stuff we saw was just utterly ridiculous. The kind of stuff you see on MTV. But we had a great time, though. And these guys were pretty much the highlight of the trip. So if anybody watches this video, I'll put this out here. I'll take the risk. If anybody watches this video and knows who these two guys are, please contact me, okay? Because like I said, I'd be lying to you if I didn't say we were looking for them in a romantic sort of sense. But it is to say thank you for giving that just a memorable Myrtle Beach. I mean, that they were hot. I mean, it sounds kind of egoist, but nobody else there kind of stood out from me. Everybody else was all, you know, old, a lot of young kids. So, you know, it's just, these guys were like, you're just right. You're age fiction, you know? So if anybody really does recognize these guys, you know, let us know. Well, let me know. You send me the message right here on YouTube. And that's about it. I'm going to go in here and eat some lunch. I have not eaten at all today. I'll take it back. I had like 2 eggs this morning. But that was it. That was all I had. So I'm going to have some lunch. I guess, is it strange to be as bold as I am? Maybe you all can answer that question too. Leave that in the comments. Is it strange to be a very bold woman? Does that scare men away? Because I think that's what scared this guy away, to verify. He may have been the very guy. He may have been the very guy in that picture, and it may have been him. But he was scared away by how bold and how mature I guess I was so loud in speaking. These car trucks. In speaking to him the way I was. So just, you know, answer that question. Is it wrong, or is it very strange, or is it just not attractive to be as bold as a woman should?